Okay, so I continue the talk. So the second part is construction. So this has many, two ingredients. So one is geometric. So this is the use of the universal family. Of hyperplane sections. So this is more geometric side. And the other is the semi-continuity. So in fact, I use just semi-continuity of the Swan conductor. So this is the linear Roman for family of curve. But so this is more cohomological side. But here I need a slight generalization in the framework of vanishing cycles. Over a general basis over schemes of dimension not necessarily one. So this is also introduced by Durini and Roman and also studied by Fabrice and Luc. But so because of the lack of restriction on time, on this talk I will more focus on this side. And by this part you will see in the next lecture. So this is publicity. Okay. Now, so I come to this construction. So construction has three steps. The first is to define, so we want to define characteristic cycle. But first, it will a priori depending on some choice. So this choice, this depends a priori. A priori on the choice of projective embedding of embedding to projective space. So this is there to indicate this projective embedding. And the second step is to prove the Milner formula. For the morphisms defined by pencils with respect to this embedding. And the last part is to show the general case and independence. So as you see, we use this family in this first two steps, and this second ingredient in these two parts. Okay, so now, so this universal family is, so you can find the difference in ECJ7. So there is this beautiful exposé by Katz. But so let me briefly record the notation there. So yeah. So it's universal family. So I assume X is quasi projective. And I take ample invertible sheaf. And I choose subspace of the global section. So this, I assume this is the finite dimension. And I assume that this choice defined gives us embedding to projective space. So P will be, so here again I take notation against Gotthardic. Yeah, so here I put the check, but here I don't put check. I'm sorry for that, but I think I'm following cuts. Yeah, so, and I assume, so we have sufficiently many sections. So I assume for every point, every distinct point, so we have a canonical map from E to this quotient divided by square. And the same thing for V. And I assume this canonical map is surjection. Yeah. And this condition is satisfied. So this condition is satisfied for so E twisted N. So this is the image of SN of E. To L tensor n for, so if you twist enough, then this condition is satisfied. So this is not a big condition. Okay, so now we go to universal family. So P check, so this is a dual projective space. So this is a dual, so this parameterizes hyperplane in P. Okay. Then, so I said most defined by pencil. So pencil means line in this dual space. So this is P1 in P check. And the axis of this pencil, so this is the intersection of hyperplanes in L. So this is linear subspace of codimension 2. And XL, so this is blow up. At this intersection. Yeah, and of course this gives an isomorphism on the complement of this intersection. Okay. And the most defined by the pencil. So we have a canonical map like this, and it's restriction to this complement. So they are the map defined by the pencils. Now, so of course this is a map from our variety to curve, but we want to study it in family. So to define universal family, first we consider the universal family of hyperplane sections. So H will be the universal family of hyperplanes. So this is nothing but like this. And so we have two projections, of course. Then the fiber product like this. So this is just X cross P check intersected with H. So this is the universal family of hyperplane section. parameterized by pcheck. So this is universal family of hyperplane section. Well, we also need to work with the universal family of lines. So we need to introduce more spaces. Before doing that, so I give one interpretation. So we have this standard exact sequence. So by this, so our H is a subspace of this H is a subspace of P cross P check. But we can identify so by this exact sequence and the projective spaces associated to this is P cross P check. So if you take the projective space projective bound associated to this, we get sub-projective space bound, and this is nothing but our H. So H is a projective space bundle. So now, and twisting by line bundle doesn't change the projective space bundle. So we can identify like this. Okay. So that base change. So this will be. So we will identify this as the projective space associated to the restoration of cotangent bundle to X. So this will be this identification will be crucial in our construction of our character cycle. Okay, so now I go to the universal family of lines. So lines are parameterized by the Grassmann. So this is the Grassmann variety. Variety parameterizing dimension. Subspace parameterizing subspaces of E of dimension 2. So in our convention at this P check, so this is lines in E. So in this notation, this will be G1 of E. So now we go to G2 of E. So this is and this is the same thing as the lines. So this subspace of E of dimension 2. So this is the same thing as lines in P check. So we identify this. So this is the parameter space for our line. And on this, we have universal axis of spaces. So A is this is a universal linear subspace. Of codimension 2. Okay. So and on this space, we have universal line. So this is a universal line. So this is inside P check cross Z. But this is in fact, so this is D. So this is in fact a flag variety. So flag of 1, 2, E. So this parameterizes flag variety, parameterizing subspace pair of subspaces. Pair of subspaces of dimension 1 and dimension 2 with inclusion. And so I call this D because this can be drapo or this can be line and droit. Okay. So this is our base of universal family. So now I introduce, I wrote a diagram here. So we have this universal family of hyperplane section. So X cross P and H. So this is parameterized over P check. And so we have a universal line. So we have two projections like this. And here I make a Cartesian diagram. And here I just put the product. And the product here, so this is a fiber product, and I write this as x cross g prime because this is a blow up at the intersection of this product with the intersection with the universal axis. So this is, in other words, this is x cos p a. So because this blow up here, so this is the isomorphism on the complement. So x cos g 0, so this is the complement. So we have this picture. Yeah. Okay. And if you take a line here, so line corresponds to point there, and so this is just for the fiber here is x. And this is just a universal line, so the fiber here is our line parameterized this. And this is, so of course this is embedded in this project, dual projective space. And the fiber here is just this blow up. And we have a Cartesian diagram here. So we have upstairs we have universal family, and each member is obtained by taking fiber at this point. Okay, so this is the picture of universal family. Now I put my single support in this picture. Okay, now, so this will be the single support as in the morning. So we have a canonical surjection. So because we have embedding there, we have a canonical surjection. I'm sorry?
If you want to commute the blow up with restriction to a particular line.
Yeah.
Yes, then the problem is that you can control blow up. In general, blow up doesn't exactly commute with extension of the ideal, but in good cases where you have a regular sequence, it's okay.
Yeah, yeah. So actually, I always work with this zero, so I don't care what's happening on this axis. Yeah. Yes. So we have senior support here. So we let me. So this is tilde is the inverse image. Now, so we take this project visualization, then we get to the closed subset here, and so and this we have identified this with the universal family of hyperplane section. So this is project visualization. So in this way, so once you have some something on cotangent band, then you get it to, on the universal family of hyperplane sections. Now, so I need one more stuff here, so it will be denoted by R of S. So here I don't put S tilde. So this is another closed subset. So this is simply this is a universal family of hyperplane sections. So we have this inclusion, and so this guy is defined as a union of TI cross PI check. So I will tell you what is this TI and PI check. So this TI is the intersection with the zero section regarded as a cross subset of X. So S is the union of SI. and PI check, so PI check, so EI will be the kernel from E. So this is originally the subspace of global section. So now you can restrict to each TI, and the EI will be the kernel of this restriction map. Then if we take P-check, so P-check I is a projective space of this EI, and you can regard this as the subspace of P-check, which is defined as POV. Yeah, and here the union is taken so that the dimension of TI is strictly bigger than zero. Yeah, so this is another closed subset which is bad for us. Okay, now.
Mean you allow isolated local characteristic points. This is the strictly super bigger than zero.
Yes. Okay. Yeah, now I introduce even smaller open subset. So this is open subset of our first zero, and I remove the inverse image of this second one. Yeah. So this is open. Yeah. So this is the largest open subset. Subset such that so Z will denote closed. So this will be closed subset of this, defined as the so this is the inverse image. Of the first one of this PS tilde, such that this guy, so this is by definition, this is a closed subset, and but I require this to be quasi finite, such that this is quasi finite, over Grassmann variety parameterizing lines. Yeah. Okay. So what is the meaning of this? So that this is explained in the next lemma. So the first statement that the four pair of points. So this pair is a point in this first open subset. The following is equivalent. The first condition is that so we have this map PL0. So this is XL0 to L. So this has U as an isolated fixed point. Isolated characters point. So we want to prove Milner formula. So we will be interested in isolated characters points. So this is a natural condition. And the second is that, so maybe you can guess, so UL is inside. Yeah. So this is, the proof of this lemma is easy, so I will not say anything about this. This first part is, easy. And the second part.
When you say isolated characteristic point, it includes the case where it is not characteristic point, or does it?
It can be characteristic. It can be non-characteristic. Yeah. At most, yeah. But my definition, yeah. But non-characteristic point is an isolated characteristic point, so in the definition in the morning. Sorry for that. And the crucial thing is the second point of lemma. So once you remove on the component, on the complement, of x cross pH minus the union of this PS tilde and RS. So once you remove this, then that complement of this, so this canonical map is universally locally acyclic relatively to the pullback of K. And of course, to prove this, we need SS1. We use this super single support satisfied this SS1 condition, and this implies this second point. But I don't think I have time, so let me just skip this point. Okay. So this is it for the universal family. So now, I need to do something on the continuity of the Swan conductor. So first I give some abstract definition on the function. So I need to generate a little bit of the locally constant function. So definition. So let F be a quasi-finite homomorphism schemes. Of Netalian schemes. And phi be a function, z-valued function. So we say this function is flat over S if just on the scheme, but just on the scheme, but I regard it as a function on the geometric point of Z. Yeah. And if for every geometric point, so X will be, so this will be geometric point of X. So this goes to S. So this will be geometric point of S and this is the first arrow means that this sent to S, and this second arrow means specialization. So these S and T both are geometric point of S. So we say a function is flat over S if for such a triple we always have equality like phi of X is equal to the sum of I wanted to write z here. Sorry, phi of. It was okay. So, yeah, sorry again. Sorry. So z. One second. Yes.
Although this was a typo on the blackboard, it was geometric point of X, but it should be of Z.
Thank you. So we have quasi finite homomorphism, and so the value here must be equal to the sum of value there. So this is the flatness condition. So this may look strange, but if our scheme is a tau, then this just means that is a tau, then flat means locally constant. So this is some mild generalization of locally constant function. So now with this terminology, I can state my proposition. So this is in condition. This is just a partial generalization of the formula by Dorin and Norman. So I consider this diagram. So this is a commutative diagram of Netalian scheme. And then, so this is closed. And this is quasi finite. And this is smooth curve. So in the original case, x equal y. So, and Now I put some sheaf or complex on this picture. No condition. It will come. Up to nano. So I have K, so as in the morning, so this will be a conservative complex. And I make assumption. So I forgot to put the name, but I can write it here anyway. So we have this map here. And another map, but related to the complement there. So we have two maps, and we assume that they are locally acyclic. Relative to our complex there. Then, and we define function phi of z as the total dimension of the space of vanishing circle. So this is to each fiber f. So actually, they are geometric fibers, and so s is P of z. Yeah, and I take a stroke at z. So we have map, family of map to curve. So this vanishing cycle carries the action of the Galois group of the local field of fibers. So we have this total dimension as in the morning, and the conclusion that this is flat over S. So I said this is related to semi-continuity, but in fact, so in Dorin's Lomont formula, if the vanishing cycle is zero, then we have equality. So this is the genesis of this part. Okay, so the proof is, so I don't have time to prove. So but proof is just to copy, apply Dorin's Lomont, plus the formalism of vanishing cycle with higher dimensional basis. Okay, now I want to apply this proposition to our situation. Yeah, so now comes, yeah, so we just apply this, then corollary. So we take the notation there, okay. Then, So notation be as lemma 2.1. Then, so we define function. So there the point was a pair of points and line. Okay. So they are in x cos g 0, 0. and so in fact, so we define z as a pullback of PS. So this is the inverse image PS tilde, those singular points. Okay, so we define this as, so it doesn't matter if we put minus or not. So total dimension of phi over our complex of PA0. So because I put 0, 0 here, so this U is the isolated characterized point of this map defined by pencil. Okay, so this is a function on U, so on Z, so this is flat So in my case, my base scheme is this Grassmann. So we just apply this previous proposition to our case, and then we get this flatness. Yes. Yeah, because I put So now we are almost there to define that character cycle. Okay, so as I said at the beginning, so character cycle. So now I'm going to define something depending on E, but in any case, so this is some linear combination of is component of singular support. So we just need to determine this integer, and this integer is defined as some value of this function we just defined. Okay, now, so as a consequence of a corollary, implies that,
So why you put sometimes the stars? Here corollary 2-5 stars. What does it depends on something?
Yeah. So this depends on the existence of a singular support.
Yeah, but you assumed from the.
Yeah. Of course, but just. Yeah, tomorrow we will see something without a star or with two stars.
The more stars you put, the best it is.
Well, I need more assumptions simply, that means. Okay, so corollary 2.5 means, so recall that, so Z is defined as, as inverse image of PS tilde. So there is some dense open in Z, so this is contained in the inverse image of PS star, PS I tilde. So each irreducible component we take the inverse image and the productivization. And this is a dense open there. So there is so for each guy, we can find such some dense open such that this function we defined there is a constant on Zi zero. So I take this. So this is not exactly AI. So maybe I erase there. So I call this number AI. And so I put some condition on project embedding to project space at the beginning. So this implies that so the map from PSI tilde, so PSI tilde is in this universal hyperplane. And we have a map here. And let me call this map P. Then, of course, we have a map like this. And this implies that this map is JAKI finite. And let Gzai I, this is the generic point. And this go to the generic point down. And by this property, this is a finite extension, the residual field is a finite extension of that. So now, so I can define the character cycle is something like this, but so now I put in the denominator. So I said that so we may have a denominator. So the denominator comes here. So this is so we have finite extension, but I take the fairly inseparable part. So this is the power of P, and on the numerator I put this integer, which is constant on this dense open. And I take this as a question. So this is the definition for us of the character cycle, which a priori depending on this E. Okay. So this is the definition. So
so what do you expect on this map? So here you said this is just quasi-finite.
Generically finite.
Generically finite.
Yeah. Well, actually, this is generically finite and radial. So I put inseparable, but actually it's not necessary. Okay. So I don't have so much time, so I skip the detail. But in any case, so this definition, you can imagine that so if our point is in this Zi zero, then by very definition we get a Milner formula. In our case, so the total dimension of vanishing cycle of k with respect to this PL0 is a characteristic cycle which may depend on E and D of PL0. So in this case, so by the very definition of this coefficient, it's almost immediate that you get this formula for free. So the problem in the second, yeah. So I said that there will be three steps. So in the first step was this definition, and the second step was to prove a Milner formula for this type of pencil. But on this dense open, so we get a formula for free, but just by definition. So the point, the remaining problem here in this step is that so we want to form this formula for everyone on Z, but it's a consequence of this flatness. so if we have two functions, so let's say phi and psi. So this is quasi finite. And if phi and psi are equal on dense open, then we get equality everywhere.
A function
flat. Thank you. Yes. This is quasi finite and they are flat. Flat over this. Five wasn't bad choice. Sorry. Yeah. No, it's fine. Yeah. Yes. So. Yeah. Don't panic. Yes. F is quasi finite. F is quasi finite and phi and psi are functions. Yeah. Thank you. Flat. Over this. Thank you. Yeah. Quasi finite and flat. Then equality on dense open implies equality everywhere. And our corollary 2.5, we know that this side is a flat function. And on this side, it's much easier. So this is just intersection theory. So I skip this. So this completes the second part. Now I want to say something on the third part. Yes. So now I come to the next section. So this is the stability. Of total dimension of vanishing cycle. So we already know this Milner formula for family for morphism defined by pencil. So the remaining task is to make some approximation. So suppose you are given such a morphism So we are given morphism to curve, and such that U is isolated character point. And we want to prove Milner formula for such point. And we do this by approximation. So this stability roughly means that if you can approximate such motion close enough, then the left hand side, I mean the total dimension of vanishing cycle doesn't change. So this is what this stability means. So we just need to compare two morphisms. So let me introduce one terminology. So suppose we have two morphisms on the same schemes. So morphisms of schemes. And Z will denote a closed subscheme. Then we say F is congruent to G, modulo this Z, if the relationship to this closed subscheme are equal. Then I state this stability. So again, I need to use the existence of a single support. So we take a map like this. So F is a morphism to smooth curve. C is a smooth curve. And U is an isolated cluster point. Then, so we have some measures to do. Our complex and single support. Then there is a sufficiently large integer such that if for every g, so this is the target is the same one, but we can go to eta neighborhood. So v is some eta neighborhood of our point U. And I assume that G is congruent to F modulo that integer. Then I'm sorry?
Maximal ideal.
Yeah, M is a maximal ideal. Yeah, at this closed point U. Yeah. Yes, then the conclusion is that for U is an isolated, again, isolated point, isolated character point of G, and the total dimensions are equal. Total dimensions. So this is a stability. So once we get the stability by approximation, we get independence of embedding to projective space and also Milner formula in general case. So this is just approximation. So I skip this and I just say a few words on the proof of this. To finish this part. So some points in proof. So it's easy to find some such n such that the first for the first condition. So g congruent to f implies u is isolated characteristic point of g. So this part is easy. So I don't say anything about this. So now so we can assume that x is equal to b, and also c is a1. Now we have two maps from x to a1, and we want to study them. So I connect these two just by homotopy. So I define h. So this is a map from x to a1. To c cross a1, but this is already a1, and this I define this h just as usual. So when you learn a homotopy in class of topology, yes. Then by this same way n works. So. So now I get a picture in proportion 2.4. So in now this z will be just u cross a1. So we have the same picture as before. So if you may need to shrink a little bit more, but in any case So we need to take this local acyclistic condition, but for this part, this is just a consequence of generic local acyclistic. By Drini, you find in SJ 4.5. Finitude. And outside this, the map is also locally acyclic by this property and SS1. So the assumption of proportion 2.4 is satisfied. And
the assumption is to have local acyclicity outside G.
Yeah, outside of this, yes. Yeah, you may shrink. Yeah. Yes. So yeah. So the assumption is satisfied. So you get the total dimension defines a flat function. But now in this case, so this is the isomorphism. So you get locally constant function. So it's actually a constant function. So you get equality. Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you. Question? Yeah. Could you explain the relation to classical story of Lefschetz spaces?
Lefschetz space, yeah. Lefschetz space, so.
You find various open subsets, and you have the dual variety and the variety of Thiel and Chesh, and you have the good. The family of
Lefschetz
spaces, and so it
could
be related to
you. Yes, yes, yeah. So we started from this, okay? So let's say our complex is just lambda. Yes. And in this case, S is just the zero section. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and then, so we have this universal family, and we identify this as X cross P, T star of P, T star of P. So maybe I need more space. T star of P. And I have a map from here to dual thing. Now, we define the PS tilde, and but to define this, we look at the surjection from here to the cotangent band. Yeah, so that means that the inverse image here means that, so to define this, I took inverse image. So this means that so the kernel here is the normal bundle. Yeah, co-normal bundle. So PS tilde is, in this case, project bundle associated to the normal bundle of this guy. And now I project it down, then we get to the dual variety. Yeah, this is the story. This is the case where k is constant. So my everything is just a generalization of this picture.
But then you have smaller corresponding
lecture. Yeah. Yes. So in the lecture space case, so this map is generically finite. Yeah. So we are shrinking to that part. Mm-hmm. Mm. Yeah.
Quadratic points, do they appear?
Yeah. In so quadratic point means that, so as I said, so generically, so this is even generically that is here. Yeah.
Side extilla, you have a nice open subset.
So we are just taking that open subset.
And in your notation, this nice open subset corresponds to Lefschetz pencils.
It's weaker. So I had this x cross z 0 and 0 0, and I also had this guy, and this guy is exactly the Lefschetz pencil. Mm. If P is odd. Okay. Yeah. Misha?
Do you use the LP approximation now in this picture or not?
No, just elementary thing. Mm. Everything is very elementary here. Mm. Except to this continuity. Yeah.
And the vanishing cycle.
We will see in the next lecture.
Another question. So, I think Bellingson introduced this sort of.
Laton transform, you mean?
It's no longer used. Yeah.
Mm, it's. There's a relation. So our shift, we had our shift here. And Laton transform that you push it down there and push it down there, but in this sense it's global because you take cohomology there, but I prefer to work with vanishing cycle with this framework. So this means that I don't go down completely. So we are somehow floating there. Mm. So this gives me more flexibility.
Okay, thank you.